somebody who cares. When I found you, found my most intimate prayer. When I found you, I found what every heart dreams of. When I found you, I found love. When I found you, I found the rest of my life. When I found you, I told all others goodbye. When I found you, I saw my fears fly away like a dove. When I found you, I found love.
Exalts Jesus Christ, and so that's what they, that's what we intend to do, that's what they desire, and that's what we intend to do. And in doing that, we'd like to share their testimony of how they both came to faith in Jesus Christ. And so I'd like to start with sharing Godfrey's testimony as he's explained it to me of how he came to faith in Jesus Christ. Godfrey wrote and said, "I was raised in a professing Christian home." He said, "We didn't miss going to church on a Sunday that I can remember." Godfrey professed to be a Christian when he was much younger, primarily because of the churches he attended with his mother and because of his upbringing. Godfrey wrote that, despite that, while he was growing up, his greatest desire growing up had nothing to do with the Lord, but everything to do with becoming a professional footballer. Is that right? As Godfrey described it, he professed to be a Christian, but his life never showed it, as he lived a sinful, selfish, and as he put it, an unrestrained sin. Godfrey told me, quote, "I thought life was all about me, and I became a lot more prideful." Then, one day, he was invited to a church service, and later to a Christian conference in Leicester. And during this Christian conference, it seems the Lord began to make Godfrey aware that Godfrey was not living a life that pleased the Lord. Godfrey began to read the Bible and realized that he was not a genuine Christian like he had first thought. In his own words, he says, quote, "I was a false convert." Filling his mind, though, with Scripture, Godfrey came to realize that he was a sinner under the wrath of God. He read the Bible, and in it he read that God was merciful to sinners and gracious to sinners who repent. Godfrey wrote, quote, "I thought I was a Christian, but I was deceiving myself. But the Lord is sovereign, and he had grace upon me. He showed me mercy and saved me for his glory." All I can say is praise the Lord, Godfrey. And as for Hannah, she wrote, quote, "I began to entertain the idea of God at the age of 18 when a friend took me along to church." Hannah said, "I was not saved at 18. I just stopped being the biggest atheist to walk the earth. I was the girl to tell you that the Bible is just a book and laugh at anyone who wanted to spend Sunday in a church." Hannah said, quote, "God was for old people." Despite this outside mocking, Hannah writes, quote, "I was desperate to know God." Hannah wrote of various sinful things that she pursued, each one of them leaving her empty, and she wrote that they left her feeling sick, her own words. Her many attempts to live life without God led her nearly to despair. Hannah wrote, quote, "I was losing my mind. I was a drunkard, a sinful mess. I needed to know God, and God knew this too." Hannah started going to church, and it seems that God was having spiritual dealings with her. While attending church, she writes, quote, "I saw my sin. The Lord opened my heart and revealed what a wretched person I was. For weeks I cried so much so that jokes were made by the ushers that they should just bring me the pack of tissues before the service began." Hannah wrote, "I bought my first Bible and began to read the book of John." And she said, "In December I cried out to God, repenting of my sins and turning away from them, understanding that I am forgiven in him because of what Christ did on the cross for me, by grace through faith. My relationship with God became personal." Hannah concludes writing, quote, "I'm so grateful to the Lord for saving me and showing me the truth. Every day I'm in awe of the Lord's grace. What a loving, just, and incredible God I serve." Godfrey and Hannah have told me that their greatest desire and prayer is that all their family and friends here today might come to know that same grace and that same forgiveness that they've experienced in Jesus Christ, and to know the peace of God that passes all understanding, and that is available to each one of you through the gospel today. That is their greatest prayer for each one of you. And I hope I've acquitted myself on your behalf. Let me just say to both of you that the singular greatest advantage you bring into your marriage is your personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. With Jesus Christ at the helm of your marriage, you can weather any challenge or storm this fallen world will seek to throw at you. Praise the Lord that you're His. At the request of Godfrey and Hannah, they have asked that for their first song in their wedding that we sing, "In Christ Alone." The words are found in your order of service, and I'd like to invite the congregation to please stand.
Comforter, my all in all, here in the love of
2017, after a couple of messages, I'm told they're called tweets, Godfrey said that we ended up in a debate about the gospel. Godfrey wrote, "I felt like I was in a tennis court with Rafael Nadal." Hannah tweeted back, "Out of curiosity, what's your purpose of talking to me?" Very direct. A few days later, Godfrey gathered his courage and asked Hannah if she wanted to go for a coffee. So Godfrey said she agreed, and he said, however, we didn't really schedule a solid time. And Godfrey said, I decided to go for a nap that day before heading for the coffee. But I ended up overnapping. I texted her and she said she's now on her way back to London from Milton Keynes. So, Godfrey said, that didn't work out so well. It's remarkable we're here today. Godfrey then had the nerve to invite her to a sister church of ours called Grace Life London. And he said, he asked her if she would go. And he said he came to the church and he was looking around to see whether she came to the service or not. And he said, I saw her in front of me and I remembered her taking notes of the sermon. And Godfrey said, I was definitely intrigued and glad. After the service, I approached Hannah and asked her, so how did the service go? She said, quote, it is very different than my church, close quote. But Godfrey went on to say, if I can remember correctly her exact words, her response was along the lines of, quote, my church is more exciting and has more energy. Over the months that followed, Godfrey and Hannah continued talking to one another and having fruitful discussions about the gospel, about theology, which is just talk about God, and listening to the same sermons and discussing what they were hearing from the Bible and those sermons preached. Godfrey said about these months of discussion, quote, Hannah was such a joy to talk to. She had such a hunger for Christ and such a zealousness, it was beautiful to me, close quote. Weeks later, Godfrey said, I invited Hannah to come to Grace Life London's Summer Institute, and she attended. At the Institute, at Grace Life London, he said, Hannah and I spoke so much. We enjoyed our company. We enjoyed one another's company. We got on so well, and I remember we would look at each other and start to giggle or smile for no apparent reason. Not long after that memorable conference, Godfrey began thinking more seriously of his budding friendship with Hannah, and Godfrey wrote, quote, I knew if I didn't approach her, I'll end up losing her to someone else, close quote. You're right. But here you are. You acted. Godfrey said, our relationship developed as friends, and sometime later, they began meeting with me for premarital counseling to help determine if they should actually pursue marrying one another. And we had crammed 12 weeks of premarital into 4 meetings, and you guys did fabulous. You worked very hard, and as we're going to say later, you know the hard work that's gone into preparing, not just for the wedding. That was the easy part. The hard part was you've already done some work on that, preparing for your marriage. So I'm so pleased with the hard work. And if you put into practice all that you've been studying and you've been talking about, I have the greatest of hopes for you. Godfrey wrote, I cannot wait to marry my beautiful fiancée. She is beautiful inside and out. And the Lord has been so gracious to me to have a woman who loves the Lord more than she loves me, who I'm able to serve wholeheartedly to the glory of God. I know challenges await both of us, says Godfrey, throughout our marriage, but I know God is in control, and He'll enable us to endure till the day we finish our race. To Hannah, Godfrey wrote, I cannot wait to run the race with you, to lead you, to love you, and to serve you. May the Lord bless you too.
I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Woo! Hannah, do you have a token of love you wish to share with Godfrey to commemorate the vows you have just made? As you place this ring on Godfrey's finger, repeat after me. I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Highly exalted, glorious in heaven. Trying to do it right. Hey! I've been living a lonely life. Ha! I've been sleeping here instead. Hey! I've been sleeping in my bed. Ha! Sleeping in my bed. Hey! Ha! Ha! So show me family. Hey! All the blood that I will bleed. Ha! I don't know where I belong. I don't know where I went wrong, but I can write a song. I belong to you, you belong to me, my sweetheart. I belong to you, you belong to me, my
every day by day, I just they celebrate. Oh. Everything I do, we just they penetrate. Oh. I just want to say, oh, thank you, Jehovah. See, I'm living large, I get angels so for my ghetto. Never forget where I come from, not from ghetto. Oh, no, 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 no. I just want to say, oh, thank you, Jehovah. Oh. Canary, what to go, Father, Father, yeah. Father, Father, yeah. Adequa Mudoya, no Father, Father, yeah. Father, Father, yeah. In my putty one nebele bello. I call look if I follow one day, you must pray. See, I come from East, the enter street, brother, you know. Is Jimmy fair? I turn to beastie, you already know. Him I know now, yellow moon don't get fe ye fe. Oh now, yellow me don't get to ya o. Him I know rap o balloon butum get se he se. Asahu balloon butum ga ko ya o. I came with saw and the conquer. My love for them does the wonder. Some wish come up and you under. My fire them with the thunder. Mwana kuzi kwanu nuju. Mwana na na. Mano chiru. I cover myself. Every day by day, I just they celebrate. Everything I do, we just they penetrate. I just want to say, oh, thank you, Jehovah. See, I'm living large, I get angels for my ghetto. Never forget where I come from, not from ghetto. Oh, no, 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 no. I just want to say, oh, thank you, Jehovah. Canary, what you go, Father, Father, yeah. Father, Father, yeah. Adequa Mudoya, no Father, Father, yeah. Father, Father, yeah.
I buy moto, I travel, go, go, no.